Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'll show you how to apply the new 3D and materials effects to your text in Adobe Illustrator. These are some great new features. Not only are they fun to use, but they allow you to create very professional-looking graphics for your projects. We have a lot to see because I'll show you how to apply all the effects you see here on my artboard. So I'm going to move to a new document and we'll get started. I'll get the Type tool, keyboard shortcut T, and notice I'm using an Arial Bold 350-point font. I'll click on the artboard to get some placeholder text, and then I'll type in my initials and get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and move these letters down to the center of the artboard. To access the 3D and Materials panel, I can either come up to Effect and click on 3D and Materials. That gives me a flyout menu with several choices, the last one being the old 3D effects, which Illustrator calls Classic, but I'm not going to get the panel here. I'm going to go to Window and click on 3D and Materials, and when the panel opens, I'll click down with my mouse on the tab and drag it and dock it next to the Layers tab on the right side of my workspace. Now, in this panel, we have a lot of different choices. Right now, Object is selected. This is where we're able to choose the 3D type, and we have four to choose from. First, I'll show you the plane effect, which gives us a flat 3D object. We can adjust this by changing the rotation of the plane that the text is sitting on. And we have the first preset, which is the off-axis front. I'll click here to show you the many other choices. If we choose off-axis back, we see the text from the back side. I'm going to undo that, keyboard shortcut command Z. And I can also adjust the rotation manually. This first slider rotates the text around the X-axis. The second slider rotates the text around the Y-axis, and the bottom slider rotates the text around the Z-axis. Now I'm going to change these back to 0. I can also make adjustments with this little widget, which is centered over my text. If I hover over and select the vertical line, I'm going to rotate around the X-axis. If I hover over and select the vertical line, I'm going to rotate around the Y-axis. And then if I hover over and select the circle part, I'll rotate around the Z-axis. Now, those are the only changes to the actual 3D effect we can make, but I can come over and select materials, and Illustrator has 42 different substance materials that I can select and apply to my text. I'll slide through these quickly, and then I'm going to come back and choose this zinc spade effect and click here. Illustrator applies that effect to my text, and I can customize it further by coming down in the material properties area. Now I'll slide down here, and I'm looking for density. And I'm going to increase the density of the pattern by just moving the slider slightly to the right. You can see all of the other different choices I have. These are going to vary depending on the material that you select. I'm going to move next to lighting. And the standard preset is selected. I can choose top left, and that changes the direction of where the light appears to be shining down on my text. Here is what right looks like. I'm going to come back to the standard preset. I can also change the intensity of the light. I can change the rotation. You can see how the light seems to move around on the text. I can increase the height so that the light is further away from the text. And finally, I can change the color of the light by clicking on this little thumbnail. And this brings up a color picker, and I'll just move a color stop over to this yellow area and say okay. And now it appears that the light that's shining down on my text has a yellow cast. Well, I'm going to deselect my text so that you can get one last look at the plain 3D effect, and then I'll select it again and delete it. Now get the Type tool again, keyboard shortcut T, and click on the artboard to get my placeholder text, and I'll type in SR and get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, move my text down to the center of the artboard, and I'm going to move over to the Properties panel and change the color of my text. For the rest of the 3D materials, if I leave my color fill on black, I won't be able to see the effects. So I'll click on the fill color and just choose this orange, and then click on the artboard to close the swatches panel and move back to 3D and materials. Click on object, and I'll apply the extrude 3D effect. And this is more what I'd consider a 3D effect, and we can even customize this further. If I drag the depth slider to the right, I increase the depth of the letter. I'm going to undo that, keyboard shortcut Command Z. I can also remove the cap. The cap is the front part of the text, but if I want to remove it, I click on this second icon, and I end up with a cookie cutter effect. Now, that's not the look I'm wanting, so I'm going to go back and put the cap back on. Now, the extrude 3D type is the only one of the 3D choices that allows us to apply a bevel. So I'm going to turn bevel on, and Illustrator applies the default classic bevel shape, but I can twirl down here and I'll show you each of the other options. First, we have the round bevel, convex, step. Then there's the classic outline, the round outline, and finally the square outline. I'm going to come back and choose the classic outline, and then I can further customize my bevel by increasing the width of the bevel, the height of the bevel, and I can add a repeat, which gives me more than one bevel at a time. Now, if I have any value greater than one in this area, I can also increase the spacing in between the bevels. And finally, I can click here on bevel inside, and the bevel is recessed in the text rather than being on the outside of it. I'm going to press the reset button, and I'm going to change the height here to 60%, and then I'm going to move to materials. And again, we have the 42 choices of materials provided by Illustrator. This time I'm going to choose this spotted concrete and apply it. Now, it looks a little boring right now, but if I come down to the material properties, I can change the main color. I'll click here on the thumbnail. This opens the color picker, and I'm going to drag my little color stop around until I find a color I like, and then I'll say OK. And that looks much better. Then if I want to change the roughness, I can increase the value here. I'm going to move down to the density and increase the density of the pattern, and that changes the look even more. Now let's move over to lighting, and I'm going to change the height of the light shining on the text. That brightens it up a little bit, and I think I like that a lot. I'll click on the artboard to deselect it so you can take one last look at this extrude 3D effect. Then I'll select it and delete it. For the next effect, I'm going to get the blob tool, keyboard shortcut Shift B, and I'll press the return key to open the blob brush tool options dialog box. I have the fidelity set right in the center between accurate and smooth, and the size is set to 20 points fixed. I'll say OK. I'm going to drag out a letter, and I'm going to keep the letters as smooth as I can, and I want to keep the loops big as well, so that when I apply the 3D effect, you're going to be able to see through all of the different holes. Then I want my letters to overlap, so I'll start my R here underneath this extension on the S. I'll drag up and come around, and there we go. Now move over to object, and I'm going to apply extrude again, and then I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and click on the artboard, and Illustrator has turned my little drawing into a piece of art. And the reason I wanted my text to overlap is because it just seems to give it a more cohesive look. And this is great the way it is, but we are going to make some changes to make it even more special. I'll select the text, and I'm going to turn bevel on, and I'm going to twirl down here and choose convex for the setting. And let's take a look at that. I think I like that just the way it is. I'll select it again, and I'm going to move to the properties panel because I want to change the color. So I'll click here on the color fill icon and apply a light blue here, and then click on the artboard to close out the swatches panel and go back to 3D and materials and I'll click on materials. Now, I'm not going to change the substance material, but I am going to add a little bit of a metallic effect by adjusting this slider here. I'll move it to the right. We're going to come up to about 0.32, and then I'll click on the artboard. And I like that just the way it is. I'm not even going to change the lighting. Take one last look at this extrude effect, and then I'll select it and delete it. I'll get the type tool again, keyboard shortcut T, and click on the artboard for the placeholder text. This time I'm going to use lowercase letters. I'll get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and move my letters to the center of the artboard and come over to the properties panel. And we'll change this to a light green and then go to 3D and materials and choose object. Then I'll select the revolve 3D effect. And this doesn't look anything like my text, but once I adjust the revolve angle, you're going to see the letters emerge. So I'll drag this little slider, and I'm going to come all the way down. Once I reach down into the 60s, you can begin to see the letters emerge. I'm going to come all the way down to 27 degrees. And now this effect makes more sense. I can also adjust the offset of the angle, and when I do, I can then change the offset direction. Right now, the offset is coming from the left edge. I can choose the right edge, and we see a big change here as well. And I could remove the cap, but I'm not going to do that. Well, I'm going to change this back to left edge, and I'm going to change this offset a little bit. Then I'm going to move to materials, and we'll come down in the substances provided by Illustrator. I'm going to apply this brick material. Then I'll move down to the material properties and make some further adjustments. Let's come down to density, and I'm going to change the density of the pattern. It's going to make my bricks a little smaller, and I think they'll fit better on these letters. Next, I'll move over to lighting. I'm not going to change any of these settings here, but I'm going to turn shadows on. Now, the default setting is to place the shadow behind the object, but I can twirl down here and choose below the object. Now, right now, it looks really dark, and we don't even see all of the shadow because I need to increase the shadow bounds. As I drag the slider to the right, we can now see all of the shadow from the letters. Now let's see what we can do about these dark letters. I'm going to come back up to the presets and try the top left setting. And that gives us a little bit more visibility of the letters. I can increase the intensity of the light. Let's change the rotation a little bit and move this behind. And now we see a really nice effect. We see the brick feature, but we also have this shadow, and I really like that a lot. So I'm going to click on the artboard to deselect the letters, and you can see the revolve 3D effect one more time. Then I'll select it and delete it. Now I'll get the type tool again, keyboard shortcut T, and click on the artboard to get my placeholder text and replace it with my initials, and get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and move the letters down here in the center of the artboard and come over to the properties panel, and I'll change the fill color to this bright pink. Then we'll come back to 3D and materials, click on object, and this time we'll use the inflate 3D type. Now this is a fun 3D effect. In fact, with the hot pink, it sort of reminds me of bubblegum. I can customize it by dragging the depth slider, and this is going to increase the depth of the inflate effect. I'm going to undo that, keyboard shortcut Command Z. I can also change the volume of the inflate effect, and the lower the volume, the flatter this effect is going to be. Let's move this back to 100%. And I'm going to move over to materials, and I'm going to apply a metallic effect. I'll drag the slider, and I'm going to drag it up to about 0.5, and that gives me a really nice shiny effect. Then I'll move to lighting, and any change that I make here is going to be really significant because of this shiny effect I have on my text. If I choose top left, we see the light shining down from the top left side of the font here on the right side as well. I'm going to come back to top left. I really like that. I can increase the intensity of the light. And I can change the rotation. As I drag the slider, you can see the light appears to move to different places above my text. I'm going to actually undo that keyboard shortcut Command Z because I liked where the light was showing. I can soften the light by increasing the softness here. And then let's see what happens when we increase the ambient light. I'll raise the intensity here. And I'm going to leave the setting at 100% and I'll click on the artboard so you can take one more look at the inflate effect and then I'll select it and delete it. Now I'll get the type tool again, keyboard shortcut T, and click on the artboard to get the placeholder text and I'll type in SR, get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, move my letters down here and I'll change the color of the fill to this raspberry color. Click on the artboard to close the swatches panel and move back to 3D and materials and switch over to object and we're going to apply the inflate effect one more time. I'm going to move to materials, and this time we're going to look at some materials I've added on my own. So I'll twirl down here, and I have several choices. I'm going to apply the calf skin leather effect. Then I'm going to customize this by moving into the material properties. Let's move down and get the density changed first. I'll drag this a little bit to the right to make that pattern a little more dense. And then I'm going to move back up here and the grain scale, I'm going to set this to small and I'll move the color variation to the right a little bit. And then I'll change the color itself by clicking on the calfskin color thumbnail. This opens the color picker and I'll drag the slider around until I have a range of colors I'm interested in and then I'll click here and I'm going to leave the color stop right there and say OK. And Illustrator changes the color of the calfskin leather. Now let's move over to lighting. I'm going to leave these settings the same for now, but I'm going to turn shadows on. Then I'll click on the artboard to deselect the text and you can get one last look at the inflate effect. Then I'll select our text and delete it. For the final example, I'll get the type tool again, keyboard shortcut T. And click on the artboard to get some placeholder text and type my initials and then get the selection tool, keyboard shortcut V, and move those over to the center of the artboard. Then I'll move to the properties panel and I'm going to change the fill color to this light brown. Then click on the artboard to close out the swatches panel. Next, we'll move back to 3D and materials. I'll click on object and I'm going to choose inflate one more time. Now I'm going to move over to materials. I've already shown you how to apply a material that I downloaded. Now I'll show you how you can download your own materials. We have this whole panel that shows the 42 different choices that Illustrator offers us. And at the bottom of these thumbnails are these two icons, which are just above the material properties. Now, if I click on the first icon, I'm going to be moved to a subscription-based website where I can pay a monthly fee and have access to a lot of different materials. Or I can click on the second icon, which takes me to a free website. And there are a lot of choices here. I can drag the slider down and see all of them. And if I see one I want, all I have to do is click on the little icon next to the name. And I'll click here, but instead of Illustrator downloading that material, I get a message asking me what I want to do with the file. And that's my first clue. I might not be able to use this material. So I'm going to come up and look at the extension at the end of the name. And sure enough, the extension here is SPSM. And we can only use materials that have an extension of SBSAR. So I'll have to cancel out here and then let's move all the way back up to the top. Now I could go through all of these different choices and pick from here, or I can come over to the bar on the left and all of the different choices are categorized. So if I'm looking for an asphalt, I'd click here. If I want bricks, I'd click here. Now this one is a pretty one. It doesn't look like a brick, but I think I like that. I'm going to download that particular one. Then let's come over and look at the metals. And I really like this metal floor rusty and dearth. I'm going to download that. And then we'll close out of this website and I'm going to slide this up to look at my materials, but the new materials aren't showing up yet. Well, that's because I've got to add them. So to the right of where these icons were that took me to the website, I have the Add New Materials icon. It's a square with a plus sign. So I'll click here, and Illustrator takes me to the location on my computer where the SBSAR files were downloaded. I'm going to click on this first one and then hold my shift key down so I can select two at once, and then I'll press open. It's going to take a couple of seconds, but the materials are being added now to my materials. We'll see this second one coming in as well. And now I can apply these to my text. Well, let's look first at this ceramic flower tile, and that's really pretty. I'll keep this other one for a future project. Now I'll come down to material properties, and I want to change the density. I'm going to increase it to make the pattern just a little bit smaller. Now let's move over to lighting, and I'll increase the intensity of the light, and I'm going to leave it like that. Now, once you've finished applying your 3D materials effects to your text, you can either save it as is, or you can save it to a higher quality. This little icon that's up in the top right corner has a little pull-down menu. When I click here, you have the option of turning on ray tracing. If I click here, then these quality settings, low, medium, and high, and reduced noise are not going to be grayed out, and I can choose any one of those. I can also click render as a vector. And then if I want that setting all the time, I click here to remember and apply to all. Now, these settings will slow your computer down and take a little time, so I recommend that you wait until you're completely finished making your changes and then apply either the ray tracing or render as vector. Now, we already have a really nice quality on the artboard, and so for most projects, I'll probably just save it as is, but I wanted you to know if you need it, you can either apply the ray tracing or render this text as a vector. I'm just going to click on the artboard to close that out, and let's take a look at what I've created in this tutorial. We have all four of the 3D types, the plane, the extrude, the revolve, and inflate, and we've applied various materials and lighting to these, but we've only scratched the surface. There are so many different options for customizing all of these materials and the lighting, and I encourage you to take the time to experiment with these and explore what looks you can get for your projects. I hope you've enjoyed this video and that you've learned something about using this new 3D materials feature. Be sure and subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell so that you don't miss any of my future tutorials, and I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.